Katniss sings this song for Pollux.
She was really freaked out about singing. She really hates it, and she was, yeah, not happy about having to do it. And of course, you know, you're shooting a scene like that that's, I don't know, a 3-page scene or something, and with a lot of characters and singing, and she had to do it all day.
Singing is my absolute biggest fear, worst nightmare. It's my worst nightmare, and I just did not want to do it. And so we were pulling up and going to set, and I started crying. I started getting, like, really scared, and like I started shaking and crying, and Frances was like, and I was like, I just like wish that like my mom was here. I don't know, I'm so scared. And Frances just goes, it's okay, it's all right.
I mean, I felt horrible, but I don't think she quite understands how good she is. She has a really interesting sound to her voice, and for a real person singing, she has a lot of soul and a lot of emotion and a really interesting sort of timbre to her voice. And I think it works really, really well, and I'm really happy with that sequence.
You want me to sing? Are you coming to the tree? If we met at midnight in the hanging tree.
That was our first day shooting. And we knew we had 9 months ahead of us. And so you're a little nervous about showing up and being the new kid in school. But it was such a warm and inviting and collaborative set, and it starts with Frances and with Jen. There's a sweetness to her, and she pulls you right in.
I remember driving down there, and I've been like, did you build this too? Like, I couldn't, I was like, this is incredible. I've never seen anything like it. And it was beautiful. The water almost had this incredible color to it. I was like, if this is what I'm supposed to expect for the rest of this movie, this is going to be the most unbelievable thing ever.
And it was incredible to do right off the bat.
If we met at midnight in the hanging tree, are you?
And she can sing, too. She's a good singer. You're like, damn it, man. There's nothing you can't do. That's so annoying.
Well, I was surprised because she was so worried about singing, and then she sang, and I was like, you're a great singer, you know? It was really good.
The great thing is that we haven't really had to chase anybody for these roles, and Julianne sort of came at us.
She wanted to be President Coyne. She knew it. She had a take on the character. She wanted to play the role.
2 years ago, my daughter started reading Hunger Games. She was 10, and we were on vacation, so I picked up her copy of the book, and the first thing I thought was, gosh, who's playing Coyne?
We were all super excited about the opportunity. We worked out schedules, and she just had a really smart take on it.
When I found out that she was doing the movie, I was just floored. And then when I met her, I didn't think I was like, my stomach hurt. I was like, I couldn't handle your talent at first, and now just this on top of everything.
But I stand here tonight with the Mockingjay to announce that our moment has arrived.
They were all so tremendously generous. I mean, you know, whenever you walk into the first day of work on any job, you're always nervous. You're like, oh, I don't know, are people gonna be nice or whatever. They could not have been more welcoming.
Just like Catching Fire, you know, there was 3 or 4 locations where we had to travel about an hour outside of Atlanta to go to some various factories and things. You know, there's some District 12 stuff that we traveled for.
We ended up finding a factory complex that was being torn down anyway to do the destroyed District 12. And we were able to work with the demolition crew that was physically demolishing the buildings. They thought we were out of our minds, you know. It's like, can you put a hole through that wall there? You know, it's like wrecking balls. I probably did like 4 or 5 different Halls of Justice. But then to finally like build the District 12 Hall of Justice destroyed with the big like, you know, Hall of Justice kind of smashed down was, it felt good to just kind of like, that's the end of it, it's done.
I've done cameras from this height, but never people this high, so tensions are quite high.
Stand by.
On a spool, there was, at any one time, 500 feet of line. It's 500 feet, but you have to have a return. So each person had over 1,200 feet of line that was a part of their whole system. The way they described it to me as they went up is it was, you'd hear the hustle and bustle of set, and as you got up halfway up, it was just quiet, because they're up so high. And they went up, I believe it ended up being around 480 or 490 feet. So when they had over the radio with 3, 2, 1, go. And they dropped. Francis wanted them to descend the speed that felt not quite free fall, but a little faster than the elevator that works in there. So those guys were dropping, you know, a pretty decent speed. And the first couple definitely got their attention. Sometimes in movies, especially with the scale of that thing, hopefully people realize that it was done practically and it wasn't, you know, guys in front of a green screen. It was actually done for real on location. 6 people dropping 500 feet from the roof down to the ground.
Actually, you're playing back, but